420 runs in a pulsating T20 encounter, the final of this tour of New Zealand. It's ended with the hosts winning it by 4. Let's talk on ESPNcricinfo Match Day about the few reasons perhaps why India have lost this T20I series. And let's look back at this third T20I at Seddon Park. Rohit Sharma won an important toss, decided India would field first for the third time in this series. And they were hoping to have the same impact with the new ball against Tom Seifert and Colin Munro that they did in the last T20. Wasn't to be. The opening duo putting up 80. Colin Munro going on to register 72 of 40 balls, 5 fours and 5 sixes for the hard-hitting left-hander at the top of the order. Had a little bit of luck towards the end of the innings, but take nothing away from Munro. He was absolutely sensational. Laid the foundation for New Zealand to get well over 200. And his record against India continues to be impressive. He likes India as an opposition in T20Is. Just having a quick look at his numbers overall now. And Munro has taken his tally to 248 at an average of 41. It's quite remarkable in the shortest format of the game, striking at 165. As a result, New Zealand posted 212, and that is always going to be a stiff task for an opposition. Let's just look at how often teams have posted such high scores against India in T20 cricket. They're a good side, the Indian team, in this shortest format. And that registers at number 5. We've now had 2 performances in this series. First at Wellington in the first game, and then at this game at Hamilton that feature in the top 5 as far as the highest team totals against India go in T20Is. Now, if you talk about India's bowling, which effectively you could say cost them the game, again conceding over 200, not getting the wickets, not keeping the runs down. But Kuldeep Yadav was playing on a different pitch in comparison to the rest of his teammates. Brought in for this game, the decider, didn't play the first 2, remember, and 2 for 26, showing exactly why he should have been part of India's plans in the first 2 games as well. He has been India's most efficient 2020 bowler in the last year or so. And while no other bowler went at less than 9 and over, Kuldeep shining with a 2 for at going at just over 6. It didn't help India's matters that there were catches dropped as well. It sums up what's been a shoddy sort of fielding performance, which is unlike this Indian team. But 2 catches that went down today, one of Colin Munro. Now, you might think being dropped 60 of 34, he's already done the damage. Went on to get 12 of his next 6. Colin de Grandem also dropped 26 of 13, then went on to get 4 more runs. But in a game, a 2020 game that's gone so close, the difference being just 4, probably the difference between the 2 sides. New Zealand taking just about all their catches, better than India, more efficient than India in the field. And finally, if we are to talk about India's chase, it surely had its moments. There was a partnership between Rohit Sharma and Vijay Shankar that took India to the halfway point where they were 108 of 10 overs needing 105. You think, you know what, half the job is done. India are on course here. And then came crucial moments in that second period of the chase. Blair Tickner on T20I debut, brought in for a rested Lockie Ferguson. New Zealand will be delighted with the reserves that they seem to be having in fast bowling in the shortest format. Bowls a brilliant 13th over that gets the wicket of Rishabh Pant, who was excellent up until that point, 28 of 16, looking good. Perhaps a bit fortuitous to get a wicket of a full toss, but what it did was an 8-run over that followed up Tickner's previous over in the 11th that conceded just 7, just took the asking rate to over 12 and over. From there, the pressure continued to build. So Blair Tickner and Scott Kuggeleijn are 2 unlikely heroes. So good on New Zealand cricket to give them a go against a formidable Indian batting lineup. And of course, Krunal Pandya and Dinesh Karthik tried hard at the end. DK trying to do an MS perhaps to keeping Krunal Pandya off strike and trying to back himself and backing himself to hit every ball over the boundary was to be 4 runs too many. Well done to New Zealand. An entertaining series comes to an end. A long tour comes to an end for India, and remarkably, it's their first ever T20I series defeat in a 3 or more match series. So, New Zealand creating a little bit of unwanted history for India and taking this series by 4 runs at Seddon Park in Hamilton.
Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and leave your comments in the comments section below. Click on the bell icon for notifications.